gets unloaded from tray pack onto the bottom line. Comes through, conveyor, into the rinser where the bottles are flipped upside down and injected with a sterile water wash to remove any cardboard flecks, any glass flecks, any impurities in the glass. It gets indexed around, flipped upside down, injected, ripped, dried, come off the conveyor, into the filler, where the bottles are vacuumed. A vacuum is pulled on the bottle to remove any oxygen. It's injected with carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide is vacuumed again out of the bottle. The bottle is then counter-pressured with carbon dioxide. Beer is let into the beer bottle. The pressure within the bottle is released through our sniff valve, comes off the conveyor through the sleeve joint, into the fobber, which shoots sterile boiling water into the basically into the mouth of the bottle, causing it to foam. So we again are removing any oxygen in the headspace of the beer bottle, into the crowner. Out of the crowner, where the bottle is rinsed, bottles are rinsed, inspected for their fill height, into our air knife, where any water is blown off the bottle, into the labeler, where labels, body and neck, are applied. Holds the labels, the glue pallet picks up the glue, which picks up the label and then places it onto the bottle. Off on the conveyor, where it is inspected again with another light box for labels, fill height, off into the accumulation table, where the bottles are picked up, inspected again, and hand packed into 9-packs. Brewing department, date coded for freshness, packed onto a pallet, off into the walk-in cooler before it is shipped off across Ontario.
Cameron, we believe in freshness. Nothing like buying and drinking your own beer right off the line. Help yourself.
For up to 6 months.
So this is just our recent fill of our
American Whiskey Barrel series that we're doing. Off-site we've got some cognac barrels, Bordeaux barrels, and our other barrels.
We'll go back into this way.
Christmas guy.
How's it going? Just checking in on the specialty malts over there.
You want to go out for a walk after the hop field?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's go out to the hop field. We planted this year.
Oh, very similar to grapes. Where the hop flowers hang down.
Just harvested last week. We're going to be doing some wet hop casks
that will be coming out. You can see there's some leftovers here. The boys didn't pick some of the cones,
the small ones.
You can see up here we got some good ones. So we got Cascade,
Chinook right here.
It doesn't smell nearly as citrusy as,
our brew house, bulk malt storage, specialty malts on the shelf, in bags, mash water tanks, brew kettle, little pool, container, and spent grain that gets picked up by our farmer comes once a week for it. Yeast propagator, fermentation cellar, deck washer.
This is where we house a week to 3 weeks worth of product before it gets distributed across Ontario.
Other side of the warehouse.
Okay, yeah. Great, thanks.
Check this out.